In a previous video, we have been introducing and talking about the body mass index, or BMI. This is a very popular metric used in medicine, or in general in health and fitness. As we have seen in that video, the BMI can be seen to represent the number of kilograms per square meter of your height. So the definition of the BMI we have seen is simply the ratio of your weight measured in kilograms and your height squared measured in meters. So the unit of measure of this this quantity is kilograms divided square meter, kilogram per square meter. If you wanted to have an intuitive idea of the meaning of this formula, you might imagine a square where the sides is your height, and imagine that all your weight is squashed on this square. If you consider one square meter inside this square, if the number of kilos that you have on this one square meter is just your BMI. Now, because of this definition, so simply the ratio of the weight to the square of the height, if this index comes out very large, so say greater than 30, which is considered obesity essentially, actually we are not able to know if the extra weight that we have on this this individual, on the frame of this individual, is due to fat or muscle. In fact, if we consider our square meter, in most cases if we have a large BMI, we are talking of obesity, because in most cases the excess weight is due to fat. But in more rare cases, like in this picture here, the extra weight may be due to muscle. So the point is that the BMI is used as an obesity index because in the large population, and statistically speaking, when we have an excess of weight, in most cases is due to fat, but of course not always. So a large say a BMI larger than 30 may be indicative of obesity, but of course not always, unless it is really very large, say above 42 or 45, and then in such a case we are talking about level of BMI that are not even are not achievable with muscle, because there is a limit to the growth of the muscle mass, even taking performance enhancing drug. In any case, there is a limit above which you cannot go with pure muscle. Instead, with fat, you can go much higher. In fact, for instance, in this case, the BMI here is 53, which you could not achieve with pure muscle. A paradigmatic example might be provided by the bodybuilding champion Ronnie Coleman, who reportedly, with a body fat of 7%, so quite lean, exceptionally lean, reached a BMI of 41.7. So we might conceivably think that we are pretty close, with 42, to the maximum value that a lean human can reach. The body mass index is a metric which is pretty useful when we are doing studies regarding the general population. For instance, we are trying to find some correlation between obesity and other variables, such as, for instance, the carbohydrates intake or the seed oil intake, and so on. Of course, if we, instead of the general population, consider the small subset of fit people, athletes or weightlifters, bodybuilders, people who do a lot of sport and who are pretty lean, this index, which is computed as the ratio of the weight to the square of the height, cannot be interpreted as an obesity index no more, because of course if the fat is very low, say from 7 to 10%, of course the extra weight is due to muscle. So in this case the BMI would be no more interpretable as an index of obesity, and would rather be a sort of muscularity index. Muscularity, because in such a case, doing this ratio, the excess weight is due to muscle. So if we know that a person is, for instance, 7%, the higher is the weight and the more muscle he has on his frame. But if we want to be really precise, or at least more precise, in assessing the muscularity of this athlete, one thing which we could do is subtract from this weight here on the numerator the weight of the fat mass. So we could build a different index where on the numerator, instead of the weight of the athlete, we consider the weight minus the weight of the fat mass, weight of fat. Okay, this new index which we can build is an index which is used a lot in the fitness world, and is called the fat-free mass index. We can summarize the formulas and concepts that we have seen. We have started from the BMI, or body mass index, defined as the weight divided the square of the height, and the unit of measure is kilograms per square meter. And we have also seen the fat-free mass index. So fat-free mass index, which is similarly defined as the weight minus the weight of the fat divided the square of the height. So the unit of measure are the same. The definition, the mathematical definition, is very similar. The only difference is that we subtract from the weight of the fat. Now, even if the definition, the mathematical definition is quite similar, the interpretation and the context of use of these indexes is quite different. In fact, the BMI is interpreted as index of obesity, just because the context of application is that of the general population, where the excess, the extra weight is generally due to fat. The FFMI is conceptually opposite, because it is an index, we could say, of muscularity. It's a muscularity index, just because the context of application is different. The FFMI index is used in the context of fitness. So it's used by the fitness industry, and it gives us a quantification of the amount of muscle that we have on our frame. Now that we have seen the concept and the mathematical definition of the fat free mass index, let's see how we can compute this metric in practice. We need the weight of the fat, and the height. For the weight and the height, of course, there is no problem. The only problem is to compute the weight of fat. Usually we do not have the direct means to get the weight of fat, but there are several ways to get an estimate of the so-called fat percentage. What is the fat percentage? The fat percentage is just the weight of fat, so say fat weight, divided the total weight, multiplied 100. We will see how to actually get this estimate of the fat percentage, but for now let's just assume that we have it, and let's denote it by F, capital F. So let's denote by capital F the fat percentage. In this case we can find the weight of the fat just by multiplying the fat percentage by the weight and divided by 100. So we can say that the fat weight, the weight of fat, can be obtained simply by multiplying the weight by the fat percentage and dividing by 100. So using this relationship we can write that the fat free mass index is equal to weight minus the weight of fat, which is just the weight multiplied the fat percentage divided 100. So we can say minus weight multiplied the fat percentage divided 100, and all divided by the square of the height. Let's see a quick example of actual computation. Imagine that for instance my weight is 75 kilos, and that fat is 10% and the height is 180 meters, of course, which would be 5'9". So the computation would go like this: 75 minus 0.1, which is the 10%, multiplied 75, which is the weight, divided the square of the height, so 180 square. If we compute this, we get in this example 20.83. Regarding the way to estimate the fat percentage, there are various ways, ranging from eye technology to subjective visual assessment. So for what concerns the technology, there is for instance the famous DEXA scan, and you will find on YouTube a lot of videos that talk about this technology. Other ways include for instance impedance scales, so biometric impedance scales, which give you estimates that sometimes are quite off. Another way is the use of a caliper, or other tools in order to measure manually the fat percentage. Finally, probably the best and most accurate way is just visual assessment done by an expert or in general a trained eye. One example is, for instance, this interesting video from Igor from the channel Vitruvian Physique. Vitruvian, of course, refers to the famous drawing by Leonardo da Vinci, where there is the Uomo Vitruviano. And in this video, Igor teaches you how to estimate your body fat, and this is quite interesting. Another interesting source of information and instruction is this series by Coach Greg, which is a very popular channel which talks about a lot of topics around diet, health and fitness. And the series is called What's Your Body Fat Percentage. In this series, Coach Greg uses his famous laser eyes to assess the body fat percentage of his new subscribers to the newsletter. So this is certainly quite helpful if you want to develop yourself a laser eye, as he call it, and you want to learn to assess visually a body fat percentage. Finally, a topic that I should probably mention is that there is a bit of a controversy in the fitness industry about the possible interpretation and use of the fat-free mass index to distinguish between steroid and steroid users, so enhanced athletes and natural athletes. All these controversy actually arised from a paper appeared in 1995 on the Clinical Journal of Sport Medicine, which, as they say, is the official journal of the Canadian Academy of Sport Medicine. Now, this article is from Corey Pope, Katz and Oliva, and the title is Fat-Free Mass Index, so FFMI, in users and non-users of anabolic androgenic steroids. In this paper, they draw a conclusion which raised some controversy, because what they say is essentially based on a statistical study made on a sample of athletes, that based on the value of this index, it is possible to screen users from non-users of anabolic androgenic steroids, and in general we could distinguish between natural and enhanced athletes, whereby enhanced we mean athletes that use steroids or SARMs or other performance enhancing drugs, such as even fat burners or diuretics and so on. Now, literally, they conclude in the abstract of the paper that the FFMI may represent a useful measure to screen possible steroid abuse, especially in athletic, medical or forensic situation in which individuals may attempt to deny such behavior. So they literally say measure to screen of course raised a lot of controversy, because certainly this kind of conclusion is certainly hazardous, because one thing is to draw statistical conclusions. You can certainly say that in average the value of 25 represent the natural limit, but one thing is to make a statistical statement, and a completely different thing is to propose to use a value to screen between natural and enhanced athlete. Of course, this is obvious that this cannot actually be meaningful, because first of all, you can have enhanced athletes which have an FFMI much lower than 25. This is pretty clear. In fact, for instance, in aesthetics, usually you have this kind of body with not many muscles, but it is quite obvious that they are using performance enhancing drug, because the level of fat is so low that is certainly unnatural. When you begin to go under 7 or 6% fat percentage, cannot be natural, especially if you keep that condition all year round. Also, on the other hand, it is possible for weightlifter and for bodybuilders to reach values beyond 27, 28, 29, even if they are perfectly natural. This is possible, of course, if we are talking about athletes that have been working out and have been lifting weights for decades, not for a few years. So it is certainly possible for a natural athlete exceed values like 28, for instance, and this was the case of the famous bodybuilder Jack Dillinger, who was certainly natural, because we are talking about the pre-steroid era. So I will talk about this topic in another video, because this is getting too long, but just keep into account that there is this kind of controversy, and it is certainly interesting to know about it. For this video, that's all, and I will see you next time in the next video.